Hello, my dear students. Welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to learn an English chapter of class 9. The name of the chapter is A Question of Space and it's written by Neera Kashyap. And we are going to learn part 1 of this chapter today. So let us move ahead. But students, if you are viewing my video for the first time, do subscribe my channel and hit the bell icon so that you get the notifications of my latest upcoming videos. Do watch the video till end and if you like it, do hit the like button. And students will also find class 10 explanation in this channel along with the question answers being uploaded. So you can quickly subscribe and have the full benefit of the videos. So let's move on upon students to the author. Let us see about the author now. As we know, Neera Kashyap is the author of this chapter. She has worked as a newspaper journalist specializing in environmental journalism, social health communication and research. She has authored a small book of short stories for young adults, Daring to Dream, Rupa, and contributed to 4 anthologies from Children's Book Trust. And she used to write essays which always interpreted scriptures and ancient literature, and it had been printed for journals such as Mountain Path and Life Positive. Means it her stories and her essays depicted many ancient literatures, and it was printed for the journals also like Mountain Path and Life Positive. So one such lesson is in front of us today to learn. So let us move towards the lesson. But before that, let us see to the introduction of the lesson. What is that we are going to learn from this chapter, from this lesson. So this lesson demonstrates how self-observation leads to self-improvement and change in attitude. Means when you learn this chapter, it is a demonstrating, it is giving an example like how your self-observation will help you to improve yourself and it will bring a big change in your attitude. If you observe your behavior, your emotions, your act, how you are behaving to various situations, and if you observe it properly, you will be able to improve it by yourself, and that will lead to change in your attitude. It will take it to your a positive level or your a good side of your life. So let us see the lesson and understand with the help of example. So here it's characters are there, Vikrant and Anuj. With these two characters, we are going to know about the self-observation. So here in first paragraph, we see that we are talking about Vikrant here, about what is he doing and what is happening with him. So despite maintaining a consistent rhythm, he had a continuous same rhythm, and Vikrant found himself completely out of breath at the end of 3.2 kilometer jog. So we see here that Vikrant was jogging and he has finished 3.2 kilometers of his jogging and now he's out of breath. Not only because he has been jogging, but because his head is pounded with the effort and with the thoughts of the pressure of his parents. He is also tired because of his jogging and finishing so much of kilometers of jog. But what is happening, what is there in his head and what efforts and thoughts have been pressurized? It is the thoughts of his parents. Now, what are his parents saying? Because this Vikrant is a college going student, and like many of us students, he is also undergoing same situation. So let us know. What is his parents pressurizing him about? They are pressurizing him and they want him to get up for the medical entrance test. Still a year and a half away. He's having still 1.5 year in his hand, and he'll be having to give a medical entrance exams. Because both of his parents are successful doctors by themselves, and so even they want Vikrant to be ready for it, and he should be able to cope up with the competitive environment which is there, and he should get good marks so that he could get good admission in a good prestigious medical college. So that is the reason they are pressurizing, they are behind him constantly, they are saying him to just give more importance to his studies and medical entrance test, he has to appear and all those things. And that was just in his mind and head, and he was too much pressurized with that thoughts. Now, class 11 had started, they say, Vikrant's class 11th has started, and his mother started harping on the importance of the year. Means the mother, you know, as usual, she was behind him because she wanted to get him good marks and good admission in a good college. So she started saying continuously about the importance of that year, how very crucial year it is for him. He has to get good grip on the subjects like science and maths. His basics should be very strong so that he can have a good foundation, because this is a foundation year for him. If he has good knowledge now about the subjects, he can do well for class 12th. So this becomes a foundation year, and all these things she used to save him every now and then. And for using this as a practice year for launching into 12th board and medical entrance exams, this is a very crucial year. She used to go on with this. And his father used to constantly come with the quizzes, many quizzes based on maths, physics and biology, till this Vikrant's head could get spun. They were just behind, mother and father, both were behind Vikrant. Poor boy, what kind of thoughts and pressure he might be having in his mind. So the conflicts had acquired. Now they've started being a small conflicts now in between parent and Vikrant ever since he had met Anuj. Now Anuj is one of the character here in the story who is the friend of Vikrant. Now where did he meet Anuj? He met Anuj on a jogging track where he used to go for jogging every day. Then he met Anuj and he became his friend. And he came like a spun in his life and changed his new universe. Means he brought a drastic change in his thoughts and his ideas, and he tried to guide him and he wanted to help him. So Anuj has come like a spun in the life of Vikrant. So now let us see. Anuj was not just a person with dynamic ideas on photography, on the connectedness between human beings and all other living species. Now here we are getting about to know about the Anuj. He was not just a dynamic person with ideas, good ideas on photography. He used to do photography, but he was having that connectedness between the human beings and other living species. Means he was able to understand the people's feeling, the connections, and what are they going on. So on special improvement as a part of human evolution on the cosmos, he had turned into a friend very quickly, a much older friend. So here we come to know that Anuj was much older than Vikrant, and he had a great knowledge about the person, about the human beings and their connectivity with each other and between the other living species and the human being. And he was having much of the experience about the self-improvement, how a human can improve himself in various fields. Because he was a much older friend, he had a good experience, a better, more experience than Vikrant. So he was like a helpful kind of friend for him, and he became a friend very quickly. So Anuj and Vikrant both became friends. So while reading a book borrowed from Anuj and experimenting with Anuj's old Kodak camera, Vikrant knew that his parents had watched his new interest with growing dismay. Now when he came in contact with Anuj and he started talking to him, he took his camera for because he used to do photography, Anuj, so he had given it to him, and the book also to read. So while all these things Vikrant was doing, he was having a change in his behavior. So parents were observing this, and they were knowing that, they were watching everything, that how his new interest is growing, and they were not very happy with this. That he's not focusing much in the studies, he's having other interest in photography, or he's having camera, or he's reading some other book. So this was watched and observed by the parent of Vikrant. Now his class grades had dropped. He started getting less marks in his classes in his 11th standard now. And he had started skipping group tuitions, even the extra school classes designed for the weekends. As only child, as tension grew between Vikrant and his parents, so did his identity with Anuj. So now with this change in behavior of the Vikrants, his parents did not like it. He also slowly started missing his classes, group tuitions, and he had dropped in his grades. He got less marks now as he used to get before. And this created a tension between Vikrant and his parents, because he was the only child, and being the only child, parent had much expectations from Vikrant. They wanted him to follow whatever they said. So now, and they did not like the identity of Anuj, like his friendship with Anuj was also not accepted by the parent. Now, panting, Vikrant flopped onto a concrete bench just beyond which Anuj was exercising on the metal swing bars grouted into the earth. Now you will come to know that Vikrant is again meeting Anuj in a ground where he's exercising, where Anuj is exercising, and there's a bench where Vikrant sits. And then again the conversation starts here. Nothing like a good workout under the blue sky. Much better than an air-conditioned gym, said Anuj with satisfaction, leaping off the bars to drop onto the bald grass. Hey, what's up? You look grim. So now Vikrant starts. Vikrant sits in the bench and Anuj sees that Vikrant has come and he starts speaking. He says it's so good because he was doing his exercise there, workouts. He says it's nothing like a good workout under the blue sky. It's so natural. It's better than air-conditioned gym. And you feel so satisfied here. And he leaves out the his exercise equipment what he was doing there with the help of the bars which were there, and he comes to Vikrant and he says, what's up? You look so grim. What has happened? Why you look so sad? So Vikrant just shrugged and there was a complete silence. He just did a little bit of a movement of his body, and then he asked, did your parents put pressure on you to become a photojournalist? So this was asked by Vikrant to Anuj. So because you are a photographer now, did your parents anyway pressurize you to become a photojournalist? So Anuj laughed and said, oh no, I started on my own. Like there was no pressure from his parents' side. He started by his own. It was his interest with journalism and he took up photography much later. And to make stories live visually, whatever stories he wanted to make it alive with the help of his photography, visually by seeing it. So he just went on with that because he had interest. Then after a pause, he said, is the pressure at home bad? Again, a question was asked that by Anuj now this time, that is the pressure which has been put from home, is it bad? Because he never had any pressure. He did not know. Anuj did not know any type of pressure. So he asked here to Vikrant. He said, bad? Are you feeling very bad? Are you having a much stronger pressure? He wanted to know. Again, Vikrant tried to shrug but nodded instead. It seems to me that the pressure is worse for children of doctors. Perhaps because medicine is considered as the noblest of professions and giving prestige. But tell me, how do you react to pressure? So Vikrant again, he did not answer anything. He just tried to again shrug his shoulders and nodded. And he said that, I think that much of pressure is there on the children of doctors. And because it is considered as the noblest and the good and prestigious profession. But tell me how to react when there is a pressure at home. This question was in Vikrant's mind now. So, I explain, I argue, I snap. Sometimes I even walk out. It is worse when I lose control. So, Anuj is sharing his experience when he undergoes some kind of similar pressure. So what does he do? So he says, I explain sometimes to my parent, I argue with them. I also snap and I'll just walk out of the house when it is worse and when I'm not able to control and I'm out of control. Just I move out from there. So these are the things he's sharing because he is already having an experience. He's much older than Vikrant and he can help him. So he's saying, yeah, but have you noticed how your body reacts? My body? No, not really. So now Anuj says him, so have you noticed your body when you are not in the mood, when you are in pressurized mood and you are having so much of thoughts and so many things coming in your mind? Have you observed your body? Oh, Vikrant is like, no, I have not yet observed anything like that. So he says, if you want to get control over a situation, you could start by first observing your body's reaction. Your posture, body temperature, muscle contraction, breathing, the taste in your mouth. So all this changes when you are having a pressure, stress in your mind. So you should observe this. What kind of reaction is your body doing? How is your posture that time? What is your body temperature, the muscle contractions, your breathing, the taste in your mouth? Everything changes, depends upon the pressure and thoughts going in your mind. For example, when you are too angry and you are having a very bad fight with your friends, a gang of friends are standing, boys are standing, and you are fighting with them. You see your posture, you are in very angry posture, just going to hit and beat somebody, and your body temperature is too high, you become red, your face has become very red and angry, your muscle becomes strong, you're just ready to hit anybody there, you breathe, your breath is too fast, and the taste in your mouth also changes. All the situation comes when you are angry, and when you're happy, your body reaction, your posture, your calmness, it's so different. Your body is so relaxed, you're so happy. So this is what you have to observe. This is what he's saying to observe to Vikrant. So he's asking Vikrant, how will that help? He was asking this doubtfully. It will help you witness your reactions as if they were happening to someone else. So if you observe that, you will feel that as if it is happening to someone else. You can observe that. And by observing your body and its reactions, you also distance yourself from them. It means you can have some distance. You can move back or you can give some space there by observing your reactions. The distance will help you first see, then control your reactions, said Anuj. So if you have a control and observation on your emotions and on your reactions, then you can control. First you will see it, then you can control your reactions also. So this is how it's going to help you. Then why not observe your body when you're feeling happy or excited or adventurous? Why only when you are under pressure? Quizzed Vikrant. So this was the question again asked by Vikrant to Anuj. Why not you observe when you're happy? Why only when we are angry and sad? So Vikrant says, sure, why not? Actually, our range of expression is quite limited. If we get familiar with our full range, we'll become aware of all our habitual expressions. But the next step is to practice expressions when there are no feelings to be expressed. I know this sounds daft, but think, if you can express emotions without expressing them, said Anuj. So you should know how to give an expression on your face while something is going on in your mind. He says it's something very daft, very unique, very weird. But if you can express emotions without expressing them, means you want to say express your emotions, but you are not expressing them, too, you are passing that message without showing any of the expressions in your faces. Then it is like self-observation and you can control many things. He's saying, like how? Asked Vikrant. So now he is giving him a demo, like, okay, suppose you get news that you have won a free trip to the USA. How would you react? Urged Anuj. So Vikrant now, the US, wow, exclaimed Vikrant, giving to his hands, body and face such exaggerated expression of glee that both collapsed laughing. Now when he heard this, when I win a free trip to US, so just listening to that, Vikrant exclaimed with happiness. His hands started moving with joy, his body and his face, such an exaggerated expression he had. He had full of happiness. The whole face was full of happiness. And so they both observed this and they understood. Vikrant also started observing, oh, what kind of changes in body expressions and movements have been happening in my body. So then both of them happily collapsed laughing. Means they were not able to stop their laugh there. But this is how he was trying to give him a demo, like how you have to observe yourself. Even when you're happy, you have different kinds of emotions and your body movements, your postures. In the same way you have in when you are sad and you're pressurized. So this is how he's trying to explain by giving him an example and giving him a demo. Then what happens next is the Vikrant's problem solved. Are the parents giving him space? So we'll see that in our next video. I hope our students have understood this chapter till here. And if you liked my video, do hit the like button. And very soon we'll be back with our next video. Thank you.